out tonight. We wasted 1 minute. All right, so that tendency of
when I pull it up, her shoulder moves like that. And I was like, okay. There's no way for me to separate your shoulder from the back of the neck. This part has to be so far apart. I mean, see this part? No. These little bones. They have to be stretched out. Right? They have to be stretched out. If you do that, then you're done. You're gonna make the sound down here, and you're gonna make the sound down here. Am I right or am I wrong? Okay, so you end up making the sound down here, which is in the jawbone. You don't need it, because what you do is you get rid of your major resonators, which is right here. The nasal area here. Nasal cavity. Also up here in the head. Down there, forehead. Also down here, up here. Yeah, that's all skull. And that's bone conduction at its best, right there. Okay. Female voices can actually emit more sound by just accessing their head movements and whistle tones. Not even here. I mean, you have to. You can go as slow as down here, which is directly below the. The main purpose of it is, the reason why I'm doing all these things, when you open your jaw and you yawn, the placement of the vocal folds are at its maximal capacity. So if you do this, you know what would happen? It goes, well, that's your Adam's apple. Vocal folds, if you go, you won't be able to phone it really well because it's misconstrued and it's off its axis. It has to be a very nice and low position, like this, to be able for you to emit those beautiful sounds that you just made. Right? You are able to sing those high notes. How many more minutes do we have?
10 minutes.
Ten minutes. So we can do that whole section again. Okay, but just keep in mind that whenever you go low, this goes low. And
need me anymore. Go.